Yesterday, you broke your neck in a car crash. Now, you are in intensive care at Southampton General Hospital. Even if you wake up and survive this, the doctors say that the drugs they're giving you will stop you remembering any of it.
Taylor, I worship the ground you walk on.
So, we are recording it all, hoping that one day you can see this for yourself.
This is the time for you now, babes, to fight.
How your life has brought you here. How the doctors tried to save it. And what makes it so worth saving.
This is Taylor Britton. He is 23-year-old gentleman, RTA, disruption of the disc, impacting on the spinal cord, but also there's a contusion.
Yeah, it looks to be between about C4 and C6.
Absolutely.
OK.
Obviously having difficulty breathing with that level of injury. Fiancé is 38 weeks pregnant.
Right. Is this his first?
Second.
Second. All right. Somebody spoke to the family already?
About to do that.
OK. OK.
Taylor. Last night, you had emergency surgery to stabilize your spine. Since then, the doctors have been keeping you unconscious.
You're uncomfortable.
Although you're asleep, everyone is talking to you as if you are awake. Because they hope you will wake, Taylor. But they don't know yet how critical your condition really is.
Hi, Tay. You've done it good and proper this time, babes, haven't you? You've always been a nightmare child, you know that. How many times we've been down at hospital? Last count, 28 times, I think it was, since the age of 5. I was 19 when I had you, Taylor. Everyone that knows us knows that you're my baby. You might be 23, but you're still my baby. You was very mischievous at school, done what you wanted to do when you wanted to do it, didn't like any rules. You had lots of friends. Some of the teachers loved you, and some just found you quite annoying. You was a proper boy to me, you're a proper boy, and I wouldn't have had you any other way. I'm proud of you, you know I'm proud of you.
Every time you do anything, you have an accident, don't you? Riding your bike. How many steps have you jumped? 6. Oh, I'm gonna do 7. But you didn't, did you? 6.5. That was one you had.
A stupid thing, rollerblading, anything that involves speed and climbing.
Bumps and bruises and cuts, falling out of trees, handlebars stuck in your leg, cutting your arms open.
Dad, I'm in the hospital. And I end up turning up there, spending all the time worrying. And there you are, waiting to come home with a lift. That's the difference. I've got to come up here every day now, make sure you're all right.
So from him coming across, why is he coming to our intensive care unit? It's ultimately because of after the crash yesterday, it's because of the damage that he's got to his neck. His breathing was a little bit odd. He was breathing a lot from his tummy, and that's to do with the damage that he's got to his neck. And then, of course, he went to theatre in the small hours of the morning. We're now in a situation with Taylor where you can see he's on our intensive care. He's still on a breathing machine, so although he's breathing for himself, the machine is helping. The injury he's got to his neck is serious. But it is, we're not even 24 hours into this, so I'm not going to try and predict how far this goes. But there is a possibility that he may not get any more recovery than what we see at the moment.
In time,
does that make sense?
Yeah, in time, it could get stronger.
The worry with the imaging we've seen on the scan that he had yesterday evening, the MRI, shows that there is significant damage to the spinal cord. The other problem we've got is damage to a blood vessel that goes up through his neck, where it could cause a blockage, and part of that blockage could go off into his brain.
If it did happen,
yeah.
Would that make him brain damaged?
It has the risk. And I'm not trying to beat around the bush. Where we are at the moment, I hope, genuinely hope, he can get a level of recovery that is acceptable to him. This is the unit you look after, complex spinal injuries, and so we will look after him for as long as it needs to.
I think you've done brilliant with him already.
I really don't. I do thank you for that as well. Okay. My world just fell apart because I knew it was serious, seeing you. And I just want to pick you out of that bed and take you home.
I think, personally, they tell us the worst-case scenarios. But I don't want to believe what they've told me. Now, if you don't believe what they've told me, then you will get better, because you've got to have the positive to make you get better today. And you love proving people wrong, don't you? So prove the doctors wrong.
Since you arrived in intensive care, Taylor, you've been in a deep sleep. You've been kept sedated so you don't struggle against your breathing tube. That plastic tube is keeping you alive. But now the doctors need to wake you up so they can determine how bad your injuries are. And that will put your life in danger once more.
We don't know how you are going to respond.
How are you feeling?
There could be complications. If we do not maintain your blood pressure, we could risk significant damage to your brain.
Taylor. It's okay, mate.
It's all right, sweetheart.
You're in intensive care, okay? You're safe, all right? You're finding that tube uncomfortable?
Yes.
All right.
You mustn't move the tube around, sweetheart. The breathing's gonna get harder, okay?
Taylor?
Yes, 250.
Taylor. You're fighting against the tube. It's making it difficult for the doctors to support your breathing. Your blood pressure is dropping dangerously low. They're going to have to put you back to sleep, Taylor. They're going to have to put you back to sleep.
Okay, going back to sleep now, Taylor. Going back to sleep, so far and go.
I wish that day that you'd hadn't gone to work. I wish that day you hadn't gone to work, and then I could have had given you a telling off for not going to work.
You're getting your act together at last. You're going to work, and if that's the only way to get to work, that's the way you took. Because you've got to get the money for your kids, and you can't live on fresh air. and you can't keep sponging off me and your mum. But you should have sat in the front. You're bigger than the other bloke.
Taylor, yesterday you reacted badly to being woken up. But until you are conscious, the doctors can't work out how to save you from your injuries. So they are trying a different way to wake you up. They have been reducing your sedation gradually overnight. And this morning, they'll try to examine you once more.
Taylor, my name's Andy. I'm one of the consultants here on the intensive care unit. Previously, when we tried to bring your sedation down, you clearly weren't comfortable enough for us to carry on with that. Where we are now, we'll bring you up gradually. We're much happier. You seem to be tolerating that much better.
Hello, Taylor. Can you hear me? You're in Southampton Hospital, but you're safe. All your family know that you're here.
Taylor, I'm going to go and chat to Emma. I'm going to chat to your mum and dad. They're going to be worried about what the future brings for you, and they're also going to be worried about the future for themselves and the rest of the family. Dad.
Yep.
I'm Andy. I thought it'd be useful to give you an update. And if I go back to the beginning, from the time of his road accident, everybody's been worried about injury to his spinal cord.
Yeah.
So we know that he's damaged the bones in his spinal column up in his neck. Nobody can tell you, I can't tell, the extent of that spinal cord injury. There is a chance, and it is quite a significant chance, that he is going to be paralysed from the neck down. So where we are at the moment, I don't know what the future brings. As the sedation comes off, we can get a better idea of what he can do or not do. What is useful for him is things like pictures and cards and music. With regards to little one, not bump, but little one, again, this has changed her life completely. We don't mind little ones coming in at all.
Yeah.
He is also gonna need all his mates.
Yeah, I know.
As much as he likes his mum and dad with things there.
Will you need the headphones?
You can. I don't mind. The only thing I don't do is country and western, but if that's what he loves.
If that's what he likes,
I don't care.
Well.
You blare that out, you know.
Hi, Taylor, it's Emma. We met in the Swan Pub, Taylor, and I was 16 and you were 17. We didn't really talk at first, but then after a while we started talking on Facebook, and then we met up and we babysat your sister. I thought you were good looking and a really nice person, and we've been together 6 years. We're just always happy. We obviously have our ups and downs, but
all we knew was Emma turned up on the scene, and then you go and split up with Emma, and then you're back out with Emma, then you split up again.
It's embarrassing to talk about it.
Back again, then you split up again, then Tiana come along. Then you split up again, and now you're back together, you've got your act together properly.
I worship the ground you walk on. I'm mesmerised by you, like I'm in love with you. I love you so much and I just need you to be there. We've got a baby on the way and I need your help. I need you to pull through and be a dad to our new baby.
You're a good dad. You know you're a good dad. You can be lazy, like all men.
But you still get stuck in there with playing. Tiana loves you. She thinks you're the funniest thing ever.
I would get a big cuddle and kiss.
No. Tiana worships grounds you walk on. Every day she's asking for you, saying, I want my daddy. I want to cuddle daddy. She just really needs you.
She just wants to see her daddy. You know, do we know the state of what you're in, Tay? We don't really know what we can tell her. So we're just saying, daddy's had an accident and he's being looked after. He'll be home soon.
Are you in any pain?
Good.
That's good. Hi, Taylor. My name's Nikki. I'm one of the physios working on the ward. I'm just here today to have a little look at your movement and the sensation.
Is it better without the collar now? No. Not really. It won't feel as warm, at least. OK.
So, Taylor, I'm just going to be touching your legs. Can you feel that? Can you feel it here? Can you wiggle your toes for me?
It's okay, Taylor.
Don't worry. We'll have a look at your arm movement as well. Can you feel me touching here? Can you wiggle your fingers at all?
You're moving your arms, yeah?
That's really good.
Oh, well done. Good. That's your wrist. Just this side for a minute.
Yeah. That's really good. That's all you care about. That's really good. Okay. You want to hold your baby?
Yeah.
Definitely.
You're doing so well.
That's a really good thought.
You're doing so well.
Taylor, okay. It's really good.
Well done.
Definitely. You have your arms, isn't it? That's all you care about, holding your baby. Definitely.
Yeah. Brilliant. Well done, you.
Moment he can move his arms, you can see he bend his arms. You may have seen him doing that at the bedside, but he doesn't appear to have any movement below that, so he's not able to move his fingers at the moment or anything else below that.
That obviously has implications for him, has implications for all of us.
It's a very serious situation when someone like Taylor is at this early stage not able to move anything other than just moving his arms like this at the moment. But we need to give that time.
I don't want to give you false hope with things, Zach. I hope I can get him off the ventilator. That is the first big hurdle that the only way of truthfully knowing is waiting and seeing.
Yeah.
OK. OK. Early day.
Yeah.
Early day.
Taylor, it is very understandable that in this early stage, both your concern and your family's concern, which is obvious, is about whether you're going to walk again. For us working on the intensive care, of course we think about that, but in the first instance, it is about your survival.
You have damaged your spinal column, but because of it, you're not breathing normally.
We do not know how far this injury is going to progress. It can get worse, and potentially it could take away your ability to breathe completely.
until we remove the breathing tube and get you off our ventilator. You can't take for granted that you're saved, you are through this, and you're going to get better.
Big breath, Taylor.
At the moment, Taylor, you're unable to cough for yourself. For the time being, we need to help you with the coughing.
Hold on, big pump coming up. Yeah. Well done, well done. Well done, well done.
Although it's a little bit uncomfortable, it is something really crucial that we need to be doing at the moment.
Big cough.
What we don't want is any other complications from that, like chest infections, because you can become really, really poorly with that.
It's common for people in intensive care to get pneumonia. That can set you back enormously, or worse than that, people die from pneumonia. People die from pneumonia.
Taylor, after 3 days in intensive care, you're still critically ill and breathing through a tube. The doctors have advised that visits from family and friends will help your recovery, but they can tire you out, and they carry their own risks of stress and emotion.
Elliot, do you want to come on through?
Go away, hello, beautiful, you all right? Hello, gorgeous.
There you go.
You all right, Taylor?
You look who's here to see. Your friends are here.
Bring the wax up.
You've been flirting.
You've been flirting, have you? Silly question, was it?
We've known each other 12, what, got coming on 12 years now, mate? The things we've done, the women we've met. Clubs, pubs. Six bells back in the day. Fishing, we love our fishing. You've been good as gold, mate. You've always helped me through thick and thin. You laid all my laminate flooring, all the decorating we've done, the false ceilings, what still looks dodgy to this day. We've done a few stupid things, mate, haven't we? You're a jokative person, Tay. You ain't gonna change, mate. Even while you're laying in that hospital bed, you're still the same old Taylor. How's liquid food? Filth.
Brought some beers out for you.
It's weirdness. Fucking weird.
Doesn't feel right driving around in the car on your own.
No, that's what I'm missing, is them phone calls. I'm not getting none. You gotta hurry up, mate. My phone's dead, mate, unless you're phoning it. Not to have a phone call or even a message or anything to say that you've had a shit day at work, or you've had an argument with your missus, or anything. It's weird not to just hear that from you. I'm scared, mate, that I'm gonna lose you.
You'll have plenty to say once that tube comes out, won't you, Taylor?
You've got to be able to shut them up.
Yeah.
So when they're looking at taking that out,
he's on quite high settings on the ventilator at the moment. He's got quite a lot of phlegm down on his chest, so the physiotherapists are working really hard to get him to do some deep breath breathing.
Getting this tube out, mate, is going to be great. At least we're going to try and have a conversation. I'm looking forward to having a proper conversation with you, mate. Bless you.
made you cough now, haven't we?
What? It's difficult to be able to talk to us and communicate with us with that tube in. Okay? But we will get it out as soon as we can. But at the moment it needs to stay there, I'm afraid.
If we take the tube out, you're not ready. You have to have the tube back in and we don't want that. You're in pain? Okay. I'll give you something to make you feel more sleepy. So the pain won't be that bad. Okay?
Taylor, the more you try to speak, the more strained your breathing becomes. But there are two more visitors you are anxious to talk to. The friends who were in the car with you on the day of the crash.
Police emergency.
There's been a car crash. We need an ambulance.
You need an ambulance? Where are you calling from?
It's on the Alton Road. I think it's the A32 at West Neon Hut.
OK. How many vehicles are involved?
Just two. There was a car waiting at the junction, and the other car was running to the back of it. I think there's someone trapped in the back, and they're trying to pull him out.
OK, stay on the line, an ambulance is on its way.
We was just told it. You heard Brad shouting to stop. To stop. And they pulled you out of the car, and you knew then something wasn't right.
Your mum is in a bad way, just wants someone to blame. We all want someone to blame, but your mum more than anyone.
Your friends have come to see you.
I feel angry that both of them have got out of the car and nothing wrong with them. I'm angry that he's walking around and you're lying here like you are. I'm angry that he took his eyes off the road for a split second. I want Brad to come and see you, and you two can talk.
What was that, Taylor, my friend?
You can't talk and you can't talk.
You won't want to blame Brad. Now, if I was where you are, I would have definitely wanted to blame him. But I'm not like you. You're different. You want to think the best in everybody, whether they're right or wrong. You're just that type of person, and you won't want to blame him. But I can't sit here and not blame him.
I just wanted to say cheerio, I'm going home now. Your night nurses are here now, so I'll say goodnight. Alright, take care, and best wishes for your new little baby arriving.
Taylor. Today's visits have taken their toll. Your lungs are deteriorating. The doctors are concerned that infection is taking hold.
We are looking after people who are really severely ill. And as much as we can hopefully predict the course, if we could predict the future, we probably wouldn't be working in intensive care. We'd have bought our lottery tickets and we'd be somewhere else. We can't.
Ooh, that lung doesn't look good.
That's pneumonia, yes. The left hemi diaphragm has been lost, suggesting that we've got collapse of that side of the lung, probably a combination of his breathing, but also developing respiratory tract infection he's got on that side as well.
And he's on antibiotics already?
On antibiotics. Okay. Possibility we may have to change those antibiotics.
Okay.
Using the PEEP as well, of course, on ventilator.
Yep. There are times when even with all the best treatment in the world, somebody deteriorates and dies. And sometimes that is unexpected.
Already? Oh, great, great. Okay, I will. Okay, goodbye.
I have good news for you. You have a new baby. Your daughter just born. She did. Relax. Your girlfriend, she went to the maternity last night. She did. Another baby girl. And they are both fine. Congratulations. You can't go home. You still have to be here. Remember, you had a surgery on your neck. I know you want to go there. They know you love them, okay? And they know you're not there because you can't.
Congratulations, Daddy. Little girl. She is lovely. She's ginger. Don't look like that. But she's the spit of Tiana. And she's got your dad's nose. I've got two videos to show you. She's battered, a bit battered and bruised. But she's lovely. Hang on, I've got a video to show you. Hang on, we're getting there. Can you see it? Look. Eyes wide open. Hungry. 2 ounces she drank straight off. I fed her. Do you want her to come up here to see you? Baby. Emma. Emma wants to bring baby up to see you, babe. And Tiana. You don't want to see baby. Why? Is it upset you?
Oh,
I know, darling. You've got to see baby. And you've got to see Emma because she wants you to pick a name with her. I can only imagine what's going through in your brain. I think you're feeling that you're incapable now of being a dad. When I had you at 19, I was worried that I wouldn't be able to cope or do what was best. But I've managed.
I knew this would happen.
Thank you.
we lose 10-15% of the patients that come through the unit, and we're seeing 750-800 patients a year. It's hard. These are often young people at the pinnacle of their lives. This has massive effect on their families, their friends.
None of us working in intensive care units give up hope on someone making recovery. What we are telling you is from our experience and our understanding what the potential outcome can be. And to explain to you, which we've been doing, and also to your family, that they have to expect, or at least know what the potential worst-case scenario is.
Taylor, you've survived in intensive care for nearly a month now. Your pneumonia is cured, and you're finally getting stronger. There's just one last thing you need to do. Breathe for yourself, without a tube.
So we all know Taylor Britton, 23-year-old, day 20 on the unit, has a spinal cord injury at the level of C5, C6. He's got wrist flexion at both wrists, no extension, and nothing in the lower limbs. Other issues are that he's had a left lower lobe collapse, for which he's had a bronchoscopy on the 9th, and he has completed a multi-in course of antibiotics. He's got good urine output and no temperatures. So we were planning to think about extubation today onto NIV, and the feed's been off since 4 a.m.
Happy?
Yeah.
Just playing with your machinery just now. Don't need to worry. So we'll extubate them onto this, and that gives Julie time to get ready. You don't need to rush.
I'm going to disconnect from the vent now. It's just going to be a break in your breathing a second.
Yesterday you broke your neck in a car crash. But they don't know yet how critical your condition really is.
Taylor, I need you to get better. I need you to pull through this and fight for your kids, for your family.
Hello.
This is Taylor Britton. He is 20.
I don't remember a lot at all, really. Too many drugs, I think. Very strange being in intensive care and not knowing what I was doing or how I got there or what happened. Yeah, it's scary. But I'm happy my family's managed to get it all on tape so I know what was going on and what I've missed and, yeah, just seeing how bad it really was.
Dad, I'm in the hospital and I end up turning up there, spending all the time worrying.
I feel like I've got a lot closer to you, Dad. It's been a long journey and you've stuck here by me as much as you possibly could. Thank you for that. It's really been nice to know that everyone cares, and especially you. Brad, I think what I wanted to say was I don't want you to feel responsible for it. It could have happened anyway, it's the wrong place, wrong time. So don't beat yourself up over it. You, Emma, have been absolute mates, and
you split up again, and now you're back together, you've got your act together properly.
I wish I treated you better, Emma. I've always been a bell end and not been the best of boyfriends, but I'm going to make up for it. Hopefully enjoy as much of a normal life as we can, even though I'm in a wheelchair maybe for the rest of my life.
You don't want to see baby. It's the same pretty much. Oh, and you've got to see Emma, because you want to, you pick a name with her.
Mum, you've always been there for me and tried to keep me safe. And I'm sorry that I put you through this. And, you know, I love you to bits. I thought it was invincible, it was stupid. I'm just sorry.
Congratulations, Daddy. Little girl. She's lovely. She's ginger. Can you see it? Eyes wide open.
It's really horrible not being there for the birth and or seeing my baby for the first time because I was in intensive care.
Taylor, there is one more piece of the story you haven't seen yet. It happened a few days before you started breathing for yourself. You can't remember it, but the doctors say it was the moment you truly began to come back to life.
Taylor, there is no reason why you can't play with your children. There's no reason why you can't hug your children. There is no reason why you can't tell them that you love them and tuck them up in bed and wish them a good night and see them grow up.
Daddy said he loves you.
All of us will remember your story in many years to come because you'll be the guy, the young guy, he was an unfortunate accident, but he got through that. He got through that injury and he got through that with the family and also having a newborn child whilst on intensive care. We'll remember that.
Having a crash and wearing no seatbelts has done this to me, so should have just been safer. That's all I can say. Life is precious now, and I wish I'd treated it like that beforehand. Friends and family mean everything to me, and I'm gonna keep it that way.
You don't go now, Taylor.
I'd really like to thank all of you in intensive care.
I can't get it.
Making me be able to enjoy another day with my kids and my family.